Hi, I'm Shikha. You're watching this video from justudas.com. So today we are going to learn about range of probability and sum of elementary event. So here it's a warm up for you. What you can do, just pause the video, try these two questions. Assuming that you have done it, now we can discuss the answer. So here there are three friends, Vijay, Rahul and Raj. Two of them, Vijay and Rahul, play a tennis match. And it is known that the probability of Vijay winning the match is 0.62. So we need to find the probability of Rahul winning the match. So we will take away 0.62 from 1 and we will get the answer as 0.38. So here the probability of Rahul winning the match is 0.38. Now what is the probability of Raj winning the match? Since Raj is not playing the match, so here the probability for him will be 0. So if you got these two as the answer, that's really wonderful. That's the correct answer. So let us move further now. So here range of probability. So, if an event is impossible, like if I will say you, there are 13 months in 1 year. So, that's an impossible event. So, therefore, the probability for such event is 0. And if an event is certain to occur, so if I will say you, there are 12 months in 1 year. That is certain. So, that means the probability for it will be 1. So, it's a range from 0 to 1 and all other probability will lie between these two. So, just remember that. Probability cannot be bigger than 1, neither it can be smaller than 0. So with this question, let us make it more clear. So here a dice is rolled, so we need to find the probability of obtaining 7. So since in a dice we cannot see 7 though, it's only till 6, so here the probability of 7 will be 0. So let us see this one now. What do you think about the probability of a number less than or equal to 6? So in a die, probability of number less than 6 and equal to 6. So there are 6 such numbers and total outcomes are 6. So it will be 6 over 6, that will be 1. So here the probability for this will be 1. So with this example, we can see that probability can be 0 and can be 1. So now let us move further and let us see what is sample space. So a sample space of an experiment is a set of all the possible outcome of a trial. So it's all the possible outcome. An event is a subset of all the possible outcome. And we refer to this subset of outcome as a favorable outcome, which we want. So this is in formula for probability of event E occurring. That is number of outcome in event E and number of outcome in sample space S. So do remember this formula. It's going to help you to find the probability. Now let us see this question here. So once again a dice is rolled and we need to find the sample space for this experiment. So in a dice there are number till 1 to 6. So it's a sample space here. Then in this one the probability of obtaining an even number. So in a dice even numbers are 2, 4 and 6. So there are 3 even numbers. So these are even. Now if you need to find the probability, event, number of event, that is 3, and number of outcomes, that is 6. And when you will simplify this further, you will get 1 over 2 as the answer. Now let us try number C here. So here we need to find the probability of obtaining a prime number. So in a dice, what are prime number? 2, 3 and 5. So there are 3 prime numbers and total outcomes are 6. So if you need to find the probability of this, it will be 1 over 2. That's my answer. So in this manner you can find the probability of many such questions. Now let us move and let us see what is elementary event. So here simple or elementary event. If there be only one element of a sample space in the set representing an event, then it is called a simple or elementary event. Let us see this example here. So this is sample space and now we need to find the probability of event of 2 appearing on a die. So 2 is only once here, so therefore it's elementary event. And here compound event which are more than one element, we can see. Like in this example, again a die is thrown and we need to see the event of an odd number. So there are 3 odd numbers, so which are more than 1 in the sample, so therefore it's a compound event. So now let us move to a practice question. So here a dice is thrown once. What is the probability of getting the multiple of 6? So multiple of 6 are the numbers which you can see in 6 times table. And on dice we can see only one number, multiple of 6, that is 6 itself. So here the probability will be 1 over 6, the total outcome. So now what you can do, just pause the video, try these questions. Assuming that you have done it, you can check your answer from this line. So if you got them correctly, that's really amazing. You're doing a superb job here. So here, thank you for watching the video. For more, please visit justtutors.com.